Hey guys, what's up? It's Terminal Velocity here, and back at you again with our first ever science video. So that right there was my handy little UV flashlight. You can see, it goes like that, and normal, and then off mode, on, off and on. Really cool. Don't shine in your eyes, it's pretty dangerous. It can blind you and give you cancer. More importantly guys, we have ourselves Halloween edition. Okay, Halloween's coming in about 4 days, 4 or 5 days. So I got a little cool trick to show your friends off. People that are coming at your door, just a cool little scary, spooky Halloween thing. I got some people to help me out here, so I have a little pumpkin over here. So you can really see it. Look at that. Beautiful. And then also I have a spider. Can't see him at all. There he is. Spider, his eyes are somewhere in there. There's Ryan. So he's his cool decoration. He's just gonna be chilling in the corner over there, pretty much the same. So we're just gonna be going over how to do this, guys. And all you need are potatoes, a measuring cup, and some tonic water. To do this, I pretty much just got this Indian style tonic water, mostly because it contains queen, however you pronounce it. So the ingredients are there. Got queen somewhere in there, yeah. Just right there. Got some queen right there. So that's all you really need it for, because this is a handy trick bag. I just turn this light off. I'm gonna go ahead. Shine my torch on it. Look at this. It glows. Can't really see it that well on this camera, but beautiful. Look at that. All sorts of shapes. Boy, this is some really cool stuff on the camera. I can't really see that much. Anyway guys, obviously it's... Whoa, look at that. Can you see that on the spoon? Can't even see any of this. Wow. That's so cool. Anyway guys, so I'll just turn that back on. Now you can't see it. So, here we are. We've got our stuff, got our ingredients. And let's jump straight into it. So, first thing first, you want to get yourself potatoes. Okay, so for this experiment, I'm just using potato starch that I've already turned into a powder. But just to save time, I'm just going to quickly tell you how to do it. So, you get potatoes, cut them up into cubes, put them in a boiler, boil them with some water, and then pretty much wait a couple hours, then the starch will set to the bottom, pour the water off the top, and then pretty much what you got is you have your starch in like little bits of powder, it takes like a day to dry, and then yeah, you have this. So just boil them, wait for them to dry, pretty much that's it, all you have to do. So you want to pretty much get a cup of this potato starch, pour in. Put a cup in. That'll work. Here we go. Put all that in the glass. Oh god, all over the fingers. Got a really weird texture to it. But, oh, it's smoky. Stuff going everywhere. Then, you don't really have to measure it. Oh crap, that felt some oil going off there. That's just bubbling away. It's pouring. Really nice of that. No. Not that bad actually. So it's just gonna fizz away. Do its little chemical reaction. Let it fizz down a little bit. Pour a little bit more in. You don't pour in too much. Now once this has occurred, you wanna get your little mixing spoon that I have here. And pretty much just mix it. And you're gonna come across a really cool liquid in a second. Now you've probably seen this on some other videos guys, where it just turns into this cool liquid. So I'm gonna put a pattern actually. Maybe half a cup. But it turns into a really cool liquid where pretty much what happens is when you punch it, when you apply pressure to the liquid, it turns into a solid or the molecules compact. And then if you just let it sit in your hands, it'll literally just float down to the very bottom. So just give me a sec to stir this up. There we go, so it's not ready yet. But it's really liquidy at the moment. It's just still sticking to my hands, so. Probably want to add a little bit more of this potato starch, sorry. This one. Okay. There we go. This one mixed in. It's starting to change a little bit. It's getting harder to stir. And that's just releasing. It's getting hard. There we go. Okay, that's the kind of stuff you want. So when you put pressure on it, you can kind of go all the way through, but oh yeah, look at that. You can see that it's like really hard. That
purpose.
And if you just let it ooze in your hand, put a little bit of pressure. Oh, actually. This one. It wants to sit there, you know? It's not melting or anything. It's not melting. As you can see, it's like starting to pull together. Is that starting to turn to a liquid? I can put pressure on that and it just crumbles in your hand. Like, how weird is that? Let's just scrape the stuff off the spoon. Put that back in. And have a nice stir around. Keep stirring it, keep stirring it. You can see, still liquid. Wow. So I think I put a little bit too much, tonic water into this. That's okay. The main point of this is just to get a nice viscous liquid that shines in the dark, which is what I want to try and accomplish here. So, hopefully this is enough now. It's getting pretty thick to, stir now. Okay, it's getting much better. Turn into a solid, and then if I just put in little balls, put pressure on it, see it's like liquefying, sticks to my hand, and then it's just like being all nice and sticky. That's really sticky. That is sticky. I need something to wash my hands with. That's sticky AF. Little pumpkin out of the way, that thing splashed a bit. I'll be back in a sec. Guys, we're back. Hands are clean, kind of. And I just want to show you something pretty cool. So here we go. Lights are off. Look at that, guys. Glowing in the dark. I can see like these little rays which are going across the screen. That's just my camera glitching out, breaking probably. I don't know. But I think it's really cool. Like, look at that glow in the dark. Let's see, even if I turn the light on. Okay, you can't really see it that well when it's like that, but lights are off. Look at that beautiful pink stuff. Really beautiful. You can see it all over my desk, guys. That, and they have the beautiful tonic water which is shining. Bunch of stuff. I'll just show you my entire room. The amounts of it just can't really see it that well. There's not that much glow in the dark stuff actually in here. Bits of that. With my desk, there's not that much. You can see bits of green. You can't see them normally. Wow. It doesn't pick up that well on the camera, but everything's like purple. That's pretty cool. Anyway, turn that light off. Boom. I'm back. And glasses over here. Get that focused. Anyway, so we have our liquid. Beautiful, beautiful liquid. Yeah. So here we go. We got a pretty good idea. I came up with a pretty good idea while we were gone. Put up a Tic Tac container, as you can see right there. They're like milk actually. And that. Anyway, so we put up an old Tic Tac container with a little bit of water and a little bit of this queen potato starch mixture. So a bit of it sticking. You can see it's kind of turning into a solid when I put pressure on it. So it's coming at the top there. It's kind of all over my desk. Anyway, so we're gonna turn the light off and see what happens. It'll shine. It's gonna go into flashing mode. Look at that, oh my god. Look at that. You can literally put this outside your front lawn on Halloween and it'll just be like this beautiful shiny mixture. Like, look at that. I can see that, like, beautiful violet pinks everywhere. Comes out really nice. The entire container is also pink. So it turns out really good, guys. I definitely value this stuff. It's not that actually that expensive, but easy to make as you just saw. But you gotta give yourself like at least a day to get all the ingredients ready, but it's just so cool. Like, I'm just gonna put the flashing mode on somehow. There you go, look at that. That is so awesome. Anyway, guys, I just gotta say thanks very much for watching. If you want to